Hey, I just finished reading Artemis by Andy Weir. Andy is the author of The Martian, huge blockbuster book and audiobook and film, obviously starring Matt Damon. I love The Martian. It is a great piece of fiction, really inspiring, exciting, super real world kind of story. So I was really pumped to check out Artemis, his latest book, and it does not disappoint. Artemis is a completely different kind of story. Yes, it's in space. Yes, it has engineering kind of stuff in it. But where The Martian feels kind of professional, because it's like, you know, essentially this NASA scientist trying to rescue himself, Artemis feels more like a piece of fun fiction. I think the best way to describe it in terms of the fiction is if you consider The Martian and then you consider Wool by Hugh Hower. That is an amazing piece of post-apocalyptic subterranean sci-fi. So combine those two, The Martian, Wool, and then I would say Ocean's 11. This book is heisty. It has some really fun crime stuff going on. So Artemis follows the story of a young Saudi daughter of a welder who's kind of a little bit of a petty crook, shall we say, making things work on the city of Artemis, which is the first human settlement on the moon. So you've got near future sci-fi basic premise, again a little reminiscent of The Martian, and then all this kind of criminal intrigue, engineering, she's solving problems, she's figuring out some heists, and all told from her first person perspective, and it's a lot of fun, tongue-in-cheek, a lot of like Star Trek references and Star Wars references and all kinds of fun stuff. There's actually some really interesting economics in there as well. This city of Artemis has been set up on the moon by a Kenyan conglomerate, and you'll learn why it's from Kenya. And so the whole place is run by business people. It's not an internationally governed body. And it's got a lot of interesting economics in there, supply and demand of oxygen, which is smelted there on the moon. There's about 2,000-3,000 people living in the city of Artemis in these pressurized domes, these bubbles. Of course, there's a tourist industry. People are traveling to check out life on the moon. Got a fair bit of strong language in it. Nothing that is kind of like gross or unpleasant kind of stuff. But, you know, lots of swears. It's a little racy in parts, but nothing too steamy. Amazing female protagonist. It's always a bit of a risky business, I think, for a male to write a female protagonist. He mentions in his acknowledgments at the end a handful of women who, you know, helped him get through, how do I write a female protagonist? And it's like a first-person narration. This book is written from like a limited first-person view. I'm a male reader. From my perspective, I think Andy's done a great job. Probably about half the way through, I began to wonder, if this is it, I don't know that I'm quite as satisfied as The Martian or as other recent science fiction books I've read. But by the very end, it picks up. It's really exciting. Lots of fun engineering challenges to be solved. Very reminiscent of The Martian in that regards, as well as reminiscent of, again, Ocean's 11, making plans and then things not working out and having to solve them on the fly. A lot more intentional comedy, I think, here than in The Martian, and it works really well. I would say this is a slam dunk for a film. Not entirely sure who I would cast in all the roles, but really, I look forward to watching this on the big screen. And if you want to listen to it, there's an audiobook already narrated by Rosario Dawson, and I am planning to get that as well, because I am a big fan of her, and I think she is a perfect fit for voicing this this character, Jasmine. Artemis by Andy Weir, go grab it on Amazon, wherever you get books. There'll be a link in the description. Highly recommend it. 5 stars from me. And get your sci-fi on.